Hi, this is your Uncle Zally, or Stu Silver. I'm your uncle in the mobile home business with your weekly video tip on how to make money in mobile homes so that you can reach your personal and financial goals. I've been investing for 30 years in real estate, and I've written 3 books explaining many of the techniques that I'm giving you right now. Here is this week's tip on how to make money in mobile homes.
How you doing? This is the 5th Uncle Zally show. And for this show, I thought I would talk about the different kinds of parks there are. There are 3 basic kinds of parks and the advantages and disadvantages of each. The first kind of park is a family park, where you allow families, children, basically there are no age restrictions whatsoever. It is the easiest park to find tenants for, and unfortunately there is also greater turnover and a lot more management intensity. I can tell you that family parks compared to over 55 parks, which we'll be discussing next, have probably 3 to 4 times the amount of management problems and management intensity that you have with an over 55 or retirement community. And as a result, family parks do have higher expenses due to damage and carelessness, but lot rent increases are easier. The second kind of park is an over 55 retirement community, and you must know the legal definition of it. This is a park where 80% of the households have at least one person over the age of 55. This is the only place in the United States where you can discriminate because of age. It is definitely more difficult to find tenants or residents for a park like that because you can't have children except for short stays. You can have some people less than the age of 55, less about 20% of them. Given the amount of calls that we get in parks either to rent or to sell units, I would say that you get about 5 to 10 times more calls in a family park than you do for an over 55 park. That is not to say that you can't rent out units in an over 55 park or sell units in an over 55 park, but there is a lot less phone calls. There is a much lower turnover. They are so much easier to manage. After we bought our first over 55 park, and it had several vacancies that we've been trying to fill, we thought about changing it to a family park, and we changed our mind because managing an over 55 park was such a dream compared to managing a family park or an RV park, which we'll talk about next. And many of the residents in an over 55 park, especially in Florida, are part-timers. They're only there for 4 to 6 months of the year, and then they leave for 6 months, and you collect rent for the 6 months that they're not there, as well as the 6 months that they are there. And there are lower expenses, there's less damage and less carelessness. People that are over 55, at least in our parks, tend to have more pride of ownership and take care of things. There is, however, a strong resistance to price increases because many of the people in over 55 parks are on fixed incomes. We have people in our over 55 park that are living on $800 a month, and with a $295 a month lot rent and at least $100 a month for utilities, I don't know how they make it, but they do. You have Zally's rule, and this is very important. While the people in an over 55 park are very easy to manage, and I strongly recommend that you talk to them at least twice a year. You have meetings and talk to them, tell them about any changes that you're looking to do or certainly any price increases. The important thing is never to go to war with someone who has nothing but time on their hands. Because over 55 people have a lot of time on their hands, and if you get them riled up, they can gang up together on you, and they have a lot more time than you do. The last kind of park is an RV park. This means, of course, recreational vehicle. The location of an RV park is critical. The best ones are close to major highways and recreational areas like state parks or lakes or skiing resorts, things of that nature. They have great turnover, probably the greatest turnover in the whole mobile home business. Large seasonal variations. It's not unusual to see an RV park down in Florida fill up starting October 1st and practically empty out May 1st. There is a very high management intensity because people, some people come for 1 month, 1 week, 4 months, or just a couple of days. So in many cases, it can have a sort of motel-like management. And you must provide fun and social activities for people in RV parks. Got to have a clubhouse. It's really nice to have a pool. But there are these people called work campers. And I have the spelling there on the slide. And they are an interesting breed. Work campers will work typically 20 hours a week just to have a full hookup site. And they will help you in an RV park. Many RV parks run successfully and very profitably because they use work campers. They do have higher expenses because there is more damage and carelessness. The people like to party a lot in RV parks, and you'll also have to pay for the utilities. It's not unusual for the expenses to be 50 to 60% of the gross rent you take in an RV park. And they are more tolerant of lot rent increases because you're usually dealing with people that have a higher income. Some of these recreational vehicles cost anywhere from $50,000 up to $1 million. And $1 million strategy in an RV park is taking an RV park that is seasonal, that maybe has people there for half the year, and converting it to a year-round park. Thank you very much. Now, I'm told that I have to give you a call to action. I spoke to an internet guru, and he said, Stu, you are not giving your people a call to action, and you're doing them a disservice. So now I'm going to give you a call to action, and I want you to do something. I would like to turn this video blog into a question and answer blog so that I can answer and help you with problems each week. In order to do that, you need to know what you don't know. And I've written three books that I want you to buy. The first book is a real simple one. It's called How to Get a Good Deal on a Mobile Home. I wrote it basically for people that wanted to buy a mobile home and live in it, but didn't know anything about how to get a good deal. And this book will show you how to get a good deal on anything, but I use mobile homes in general. And it's in a PDF format, so when you buy it, it instantly gets sent to you. Then I have my second book, which is right here. Let me move the pointer over. Right there, there's the second book, Mobile Home Wealth. It is on how to invest in individual mobile homes. It actually will teach you how to invest in property in general, and I use individual mobile homes as the example. It is only $19.95. My last book there, right on the bottom, is Mobile Home Wealth Part 2, and that is 650 pages. By the way, Mobile Home Wealth above it is 450 pages. Mobile Home Wealth Part 2 is how to make money in mobile home parks, which is a distinctly different investment. Now, if you buy the Mobile Home Wealth Part 1, that I call it right here, I will give you how to get a good deal on a mobile home for free. And if you buy Mobile Home Wealth Part 2, I will give you both books above it for free. I'll give you the Good Deal book and the Mobile Home Wealth Part 1 on how to make money in individual mobile homes. The way to buy them is to go to my website, and up along the header, there's a tab that says Books and Kits. Just click on that. I have a secure shopping cart that you can purchase it by using a credit card. Then you can send me your question, and we can play Stump the Uncle. You can stump your Uncle Zally. And I got to tell you something. I love tough questions. I love questions that make me think and help me grow along with you. So that's what I would like to do. I would like to turn this blog into a question and answer video blog where I can help you with problems that you have. Thank you very much.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this week's strategy on how to make money with mobile homes, and I hope this helps you to reach your personal and financial goals. Remember, you now have an uncle in the mobile home business, and when Zally is your uncle, I'm your uncle for life. No phone, no